Right here on the Universal lot, Michael Jackson made the video for Scream. Hi, I'm Allison Stewart from MTV News, and we will have that video for you very shortly. Now, of course, when Michael Jackson makes a video, it is always an event. But this time, he is literally making history. Scream is a duet with his sister Janet, and it marks the first time that Michael's ever recorded with his superstar sibling. And of course, Janet's going to be in the video as well. And see that soundstage behind me? It is one of five housing 10 sets used in this $7 million project. In terms of the visuals that they're applying to Scream, what do you think about the combination? Does it work for you?
Yeah, I think the combination is really cool because it kind of is taking place in a spaceship or kind of in a vacuum. I think the spaceship is kind of a metaphor of the vacuum that their lives sort of are. Sometimes they're looked upon as not human. Of course, they are human, but maybe that's kind of a surrealistic way to say that, you know, here we are out in space and we're connecting with each other as brother and sister.
We wrote the song together. It was fun. The first time we've ever worked together, sang together, aside from PYT, but that's just a little background thing he asked me to do, so I said yes and did it. That was years ago.
It's been 13 years since Michael Jackson's kid sister added some backing vocals to his album, Thriller. Janet Jackson's now a superstar in her own right, and clearly she and her brother have a mutual respect that transcends the personal to professional levels, as was evident from a very public show of affection at the 1993 Grammy Awards.
I'm pleased to be here tonight to honor the man I love and admire as an artist and a person, my brother, Michael Jackson. I just wanted to tell you how proud I am of you and how much you've inspired me and how proud I am to be your sister and how much I love you. I do.
Me and Janet really are two different people.
Most definitely, I did feel that little sister thing. It'll always be that way because that's what I am. And he's my big brother.
Scream isn't simply a collaboration between two artists. It's the melding of two creative camps. Both Michael and Janet Jackson have brought his and her inner circle to the project to create the Scream team. You are instrumental in Janet's success as an artist. Did she bring you aboard this project, say, hey, Jimmy, come work with me and my brother?
Yes, she did. She, you know, tied us up, beat us over our head, and said, you will do this duet. You will do this duet.
Michael and Janet Jackson are both well known for their innovative dance steps. But Janet now lends a certain street credibility to Michael's pedestal popularity. To communicate the combination of these two styles, four choreographers were employed for the staging of Scream. You hear co-directing and co-producing, but you don't hear of co-choreographers very often.
Yeah, but I mean, when you get Michael Jackson and Janet Jackson, you got to have, you know, best of both worlds. So It wouldn't be fair to exclude one entity because, you know, we've both had significant roles in, you know, the visual appeal.
We are working with Janet, and Travis and Lavelle are working mostly with Michael, but then at one point when they are working together, it's kind of all four of us come together and just collaborate and use as many as many ideas and energies that we can.
But there are differences, you know, movement-wise. Janet, she thrashes. I mean, that girl will, you know, she'll go for it, you know. And Michael will do the same thing, but it's just where his presence is just so much different than hers, you know. She's the hard hitter. Michael goes between, you know, soft, supple movement to crash and burn.
While Michael's look hasn't changed dramatically for the video, Janet's adopted quite a different video persona.
She's been looking very sort of soft and golden and very sexy and everything. And he wanted something that looked very raw. And as we started talking about it and started talking about the futuristic sort of aspect of it, the idea of her looking sort of like Edward Scissorhands meets, you know, futuristic sort of Japanese superhero.
Minimalism were the buzzwords used to describe Scream. To turn the futuristic fantasy into a reality, Jackson turned to the video director of the moment, Mark Romanek. He's the eye behind breakthrough clips for Madonna, Nine Inch Nails, Lenny Kravitz, En Vogue, and R.E.M.
Mark has got a great track record, and he's very creative, very innovative, so it only seemed right that, you know, he would be working on this with Michael and Janet.
Michael, take a step just in front of the ramp.
I've always wanted to work with Mark. I think he's an absolute genius, and I was so freaked out and excited that I was gonna be able to work with him on this video. The Rain video, Constant Craving, the En Vogue, Free Your Mind video, I mean, they were all so revolutionary. And still, when you look at them today, they look like, even 10 years from now, they would look revolutionary. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're just so beautifully done. The lighting is perfect. The cuts are all perfect. You could push the pause button on any of Mark's videos, and they're like these beautiful photographs.
This is the Zen Garden set, one of the many you will see in the video Scream, the first release from Michael Jackson's album, History, Past, Present, and Future, Book One. We'll get into the making of that album next, and of course show you Scream in its entirety when we return. History, Past, Present, and Future, Book One. That mouthful is the title of Michael Jackson's long-awaited and long-delayed album of 15 greatest hits, which have been digitally remastered, and 15 new tracks. Now, this is a very important album for Michael Jackson. Not only is it his first release of new material since 1991's Dangerous, it's his first musical statement following the tumultuous events and the intense scrutiny of the past few years. Michael Jackson has led a public life. Recently, however, the private aspects of his life have overshadowed his musical output. From his highly publicized string of appearances in early 1993 to the specter of child molestation charges that were filed that fall and subsequently dropped, then settled out of court with Jackson cleared.
I am totally innocent of any wrongdoing.
There was his admission of addiction to painkillers and a surprise marriage to Elvis Presley's daughter, Lisa Marie.
And just think, nobody thought this would last.
The combination of events left many wondering how his experience would manifest itself in his music.
If you're an artist and you put your feelings on your record and in your music, it gives it a whole different energy than it would have if you're just singing, you know, well, la da down, whatever. He sang what was on his mind, and it's a very aggressive, very personal album. And it's, you know, to me, it's his finest album, just because of that fact.
Scream is a full-on battle cry, with a pissed-off Michael going on the offensive, lambasting his critics.
They wanted the song to be very aggressive. It was interesting. Somebody asked me, you know, what's the song like? And I said, well, it ain't a ballad, you know? It's not a ballad. It's very tough and very aggressive. And lyrically, it's very aggressive, too. And it had to be up-tempo, obviously, so they can move and dance and do their thing to it. So just trying to match the song to kind of what they were feeling, you know, lyrically was what we tried to do.
It was very interesting to see him work at work because I hadn't seen him in a really long time. I think the last time I saw him at work was the Thriller album. Just being there in the studio with him, just watching, observing. So it was fun. It was a lot of fun. We had a great time. We reminisced and laughed a lot. And just had a really good time.
Janet also is showing a lot of support for her brother, you know, because this is a big album for him. It's coming back after a long period of time, a lot of turmoil in his life. And it's an important album for him, and I think that's the other thing, too, is that she's just happy to be there and support him.
Also joining Michael Jackson for this project are Slash, the Notorious B.I.G., Shaquille O'Neal, producer Dallas Austin, R. Kelly, and Boyz II Men.
It was exciting. I mean, you know, being in the studio with Michael Jackson. For one, Michael wasn't even supposed to be in the studio. He had a session at another studio, and he actually moved his session over to our studio just so he could be involved in the session.
You don't think you're gonna ever get a chance to talk to him because, you know, you people think that he's so untouchable, and that's the way we felt until we actually talked to him and met him.
They don't necessarily consider him as being a very, like, intelligent entrepreneur, you know what I'm saying? They just see him as this guy that has pale skin and, you know, he's buying bones and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? Things like, they go for the real, the sensationalism of the whole thing, so they don't really consider him as even being a real human.
One thing I can tell you is you got to be free. Come together.
The new album contains 14 new tracks, along with a cover of The Beatles' Come Together, originally recorded for the Moonwalker film. Not to be overlooked is the inclusion of 15 of Michael Jackson's greatest hits, digitally remastered.
CD technology back when Off the Wall and Thriller and some of those records came out was still a very new technology. And, you know, any technology gets better and better and better. And it's just a totally different, it's like hearing the songs for the first time. Actually hear things in the song that you've never heard before. They were always there, but because the technology was new, people didn't know how to actually put it on CD and do it the right way. So it's a pretty amazing process.
The two CD set includes a 52-page booklet complete with sketches, photos of Michael and friends, testimonials from those friends, and a listing of Jackson's various achievements. Before there was even a video shot for the song Scream, there was a trailer shot for the album, a multi-million dollar trailer of epic proportions, simply to announce the arrival of the new release.
Budapest, Hungary, we had thousands of soldiers from different regions in the world, and we staged and choreographed along with Michael, the soldiers, as well as, you know, his bits and
flag men, everything. We had flag men, rifles, and you name it, we choreographed it.
What was the message you were trying to put forth?
Power. And he's back.
Power and unity.
Power and he's back with a vengeance.
Back with a vengeance indeed. Michael Jackson, along with his label Epic Records, is launching a full-scale marketing assault. And so far, it's working. The first single, Scream, had the highest debut ever in the history of the Billboard singles charts, entering at number 5. It also includes Childhood from the movie Free Willy 2.
You've seen my childhood.
And up next, you'll see the fierce and futuristic video that is Scream. It's Michael Jackson and Janet Jackson next.